Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Christ has entered, not into a sanctuary made with hands, a copy of the true one, but into heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God on our behalf.
And our mouths shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast, not with old leaven, the leaven of malice and evil, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Alleluia. Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death that he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So also consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Alleluia. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so in Christ shall all be made alive. Alleluia.
The psalm appointed for this morning is Psalm 66. Bless our God, you peoples. Make the voice of his praise to be heard, who holds our souls in life, and will not allow our feet to slip. For you, O God, have proved us. You have tried us just as silver is tried. You brought us into the snare. You laid heavy burdens upon our backs. You let enemies ride over our heads. We went through fire and water, but you brought us out into a place of refreshment. I will enter your house with burnt offerings and will pay you my vows, which I promised with my lips and spoke with my mouth when I was in trouble. I will offer you sacrifices of fat beasts with the smoke of rams. I will give you oxen and goats. Come and listen, all you who fear God, and I will tell you what he has done for me. I called out to him with my mouth, and his praise was on my tongue. If I had found evil in my heart, the Lord would not have heard me. But in truth, God has heard me. He has attended to the voice of my prayer. Blessed be God, who has not rejected my prayer, nor withheld his love from me. This morning's first lesson is taken from the books of the Acts of the Apostles. Paul stood in front of the Areopagus and said, "Athenians, I see how extremely religious you are in every way. For as I went through the city and looked carefully at the objects of your worship, I found among them an altar with the inscription, 'To an unknown God.' What therefore you worship as unknown, this I proclaim to you. The God who made the world and everything in it, he who is Lord of heaven and earth, does not live in shrines made by human hands, nor is he served by human hands as though he needed anything, since he himself gives to all mortals life and breath and all things. From one ancestor he made all nations to inhabit the whole earth, and he allotted the times of their existence and the boundaries of the places where they would live, so that they would search for God, and perhaps grope for him and find him. Though indeed he is not far from each one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being, as even some of your own poets have said, for we too are his offspring. Since we are God's offspring, we ought not to think that the deity is like gold or silver or stone, an image formed by the art and imagination of mortals. While God has overlooked the times of human ignorance, now he commands all people everywhere to repent, because he has fixed a day on which he will have the world judged in righteousness by a man whom he has appointed, and of this he has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead."
We continue with the canticle, the Song of Moses.
I will sing to the Lord, for he is lofty and uplifted. The horse and its rider has he hurled into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my refuge. The Lord has become my Savior. This is my God, and I will praise him, the God of my people, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a mighty warrior. Yahweh is his name. The chariots of Pharaoh and his army has he hurled into the sea. The finest of those who bear armor have been drowned in the Red Sea. The fathomless deep has overwhelmed them. They sank into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, is glorious in might. Your right hand, O Lord, has overthrown the enemy. Who can be compared with you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you, glorious in holiness, awesome in renown, and worker of wonders? You stretched forth your right hand, the earth swallowed them up. With your constant love, you led the people you redeemed. With your might, you brought them in safety to your holy dwelling. You will bring them in and plant them on the mount of your possession, the resting place you have made for yourself, O Lord, the sanctuary, O Lord, that your hand has established. The Lord shall reign forever and forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. This morning's second reading is taken from the first letter of Peter. Now who will harm you if you are eager to do what is good? But even if you do suffer for doing what is right, you are blessed. Do not fear what they fear, and do not be intimidated, but in your hearts sanctify Christ as Lord. Always be ready to make your defense to anyone who demands from you an accounting for the hope that is in you. Yet do it with gentleness and reverence. Keep your conscience clear, so that when you are maligned, those who abuse you for your good conduct in Christ may be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if suffering should be God's will, than to suffer for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, in order to bring you to God. He was put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the spirit, in which also he went and made a proclamation to the spirits in prison, who in former times did not obey, when God waited patiently in the days of Noah, during the building of the ark, in which a few, that is, eight persons, were saved through water. And baptism, which this prefigured, now saves you, not as a removal of dirt from the body, but as an appeal to God for a good conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone to heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers made subject to him.
We continue with the canticle, the Song of the Redeemed.
O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages. Who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Our gospel for this morning is from John chapter 14, verses 15 to 21. Jesus said, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. On that day, you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me. And those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them."
Where we'll be saved. to town.
I pray we'll find your light
nel cuore d'estana,
and hold it in our heart
a ricordarci che
when stars go out each night
l'eterna stella se nella mia.
Have you ever noticed how insecure most of us are? Even those of us who appear to be so self-confident on the outside have issues on the inside. Some of us have difficulty in making decisions. Some of us don't like to talk in front of groups of people. Some of us don't like to drive in traffic. Some of us don't like heights. Some of us don't like to be in the spotlight. Every one of us has something that puts us on edge. When I was a child on the school playground, I wanted to climb up and hand by hand swing across that long horizontal ladder way above my head and make it to the other side. But I knew I couldn't do it. It was too high. It was too far. I could climb up, put my hands on the rungs, but I couldn't let myself go and swing from one rung to the other until I came to the end. I never did it. And it would be the greatest fib of the century to say that my teenage years were not filled with insecurity and anxiety. We could spend hours talking about those times. And then there was no manual to teach me about becoming an adult and fending for myself. But I don't think that I'm the only person who grew up with these kinds of feelings. We all know that there is some fear of the unknown. We all have feelings of insecurity when we encounter situations that will not only have a huge impact on our lives, but are also out of our control. We're living in that time right now as we travel through this COVID-19 pandemic. We have so many questions, and there are so few answers. We wait, fearful for what may happen tomorrow to us or to our loved ones. Nothing is the same anymore. We've lost our security blanket. Through the words of Jesus in our gospel today, we can sense that the disciples are feeling insecure. Again, Jesus tells them that he will be leaving them soon. Now for a moment, let's try to put ourselves in this picture with them. Let's see if we can feel the emotion that the disciples are experiencing. These men have been friends with Jesus for several years now. They've traveled with him and listened to him preach. They've seen him perform miracles that can't be explained. They've tried to understand the parables that he told when he was teaching. They were with him in his last hours, and they suffered when he died. They were astounded and overjoyed when they saw him again after his death. And now they are confused as Jesus tells him that he will be leaving them, and yet he will be with them. Again, they will lose their friend. And in addition to that, Jesus expects that they will continue the work that he started, that they will work for the kingdom of God here on earth. How ever are they going to do that? They aren't Jesus. They can't possibly do that. They don't even know how or where to begin. That's a huge responsibility. Talk about feelings of insecurity. But Jesus has words of reassurance for them. They won't be doing this alone. Jesus, working through the Holy Spirit, will be with them, working through them. These words that Jesus speaks to the disciples are spoken to us, too. Jesus reassures us that although we can't see him, he is with us, and the Holy Spirit is within us. There should be no uncertainty about what it is God wants us to do. There should be no doubts or fears that we can accomplish God's goals for us. Jesus has given us the tools to do our job. Jesus has given us confidence to do God's work because he has told us how to do the work. There's a lot of love that flourishes within our worshiping community. We care for each other like family, and we care deeply for each other. No doubt this virus is making us more aware of the needs of our fellow parishioners, while it's also opening our eyes to the conditions of those who are directly affected by the virus. But the virus has not put an end to the plague of social ills still alive through the world. We still see political oppression and war, poverty and starvation, physical and mental illness, disrespect of basic human rights. We have some of these problems here within our own country, even within our own community. We can't expect our government to solve all these problems. Our governmental systems are jammed, our taxpayers are overburdened. Where, then, can help be found? Well, we need look no further than the message in our gospel this morning. If we love Jesus and follow his commandments, if we love God unconditionally and love and care for others as much as we do ourselves, then we will be empowered by the Holy Spirit. God's love for us is unconditional. Shouldn't our love for God be unconditional as well? Even though at times we may be at odds with God, we are forgiven and still loved. And shouldn't we extend that love to all our brothers and sisters? To solve all the problems within the world, including our own community, is a task far beyond our capabilities, but we can contribute to a solution. Let the Holy Spirit guide us in prayer and in action. Let the Holy Spirit banish our insecurities and remind us of the love and reassurance that Jesus gave to the disciples and to us. And may the Holy Spirit strengthen us and empower us to persevere through all the adversities we face. Amen. We continue with the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care,
and guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth,
your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten,
nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God,
and sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
Let us pray. O God, you have prepared for those who love you such good things as surpass our understanding. Pour into all our hearts such love towards you, that we, loving you in all things and above all things, may obtain your promises, which exceed all that we can desire. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, you make us glad with the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of your Son, our Lord. Give us this day such blessing through our worship of you, that the week to come may be spent in your favor. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, the King eternal, whose light divides the day from the night and turns the shadow of death into the morning, drive far from us all wrong desires. Incline our hearts to keep your law. Guide our feet into the way of peace, that having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, when night comes, rejoice to give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you is eternal life, and to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us, your humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in your defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord God, almighty and everlasting Father, you have brought us in safety to this new day. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin, nor be overcome by adversity. And in all we do, direct us to the fulfilling of your purpose. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Heavenly Father, in you we live and move and have our being. We humbly pray you so to guide and govern us by your Holy Spirit, that in all the cares and occupations of our life we may not forget you, but may remember that we are ever walking in your sight. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hard wood of the cross, that everyone might come within reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your Spirit, that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you, for the honor of your name.
Amen. Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the people and those who govern this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all those whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, especially all who are afflicted by COVID-19. Give to them and to all who care for them courage and hope, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled, and we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Lord, hear the prayers of your people, and what we have asked for faithfully, grant that we may obtain effectually to the glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace, and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to Him from generation to generation in the Church, and in Christ Jesus forever and ever.
Amen.
But deliver us from evil.